So we have graduation today.
Woo!
Woo!
Steve came to us right at 90 days ago. I went and actually picked him up from the Department of Corrections. And so I go in and present myself and tell them, you know, who I'm there to see, and they have to go see if they've got such a creature. And lo and behold, about 5-10 minutes later, long enough for me to start being uncomfortable in there, Steve comes walking out. He's got his whole worldly belongings in a little box. Not a big box, just a little box. And his eyes are about 3 times the size you see them today. And so we go out, we get in a suburban, and we spent the next 6 hours trying to get 3 government agencies to give us a go-ahead to let him come back with us. But we had a chance to talk during that time and kind of get to know each other. And it's just been an incredible pleasure to see the Steve that sits before you today and all the changes that have happened in such a short amount of time.
Amen.
And Steve, I am so thankful that you are continuing with your time with us and are going over to payroll.
Yeah, you know, this is this time really, Steve, it's all about you, brother. But it's also about us. It really is, you know. For those of you who don't know, and I got Steve's permission to kind of tell you a little bit, he spent the better part of the last 20 years in prison. Mm-hmm. And 90 days ago today, he woke up in prison cell. That night, or that day, I guess, Tom picked him up and did everything that Tom was just talking about. And we were actually having a house meal there at Ethos. And so Steve walks into the kitchen and there's 6 guys just, you know, making all kinds of noise, moving around, you know what I mean, walking in there, and his eyes were probably 3 times as big as they were when Tom was talking about. But Steve learned real quick that we do things a little bit differently around here. It's not survival of the fittest like the world he was used to.
Yes.
Like the world tried to make him, you know. Steve made a lot of mistakes, yeah, he did, you know, but we all do. You know, I'm gonna read something to everybody. Now, this is Jesus talking here. These are red letters. He says, "Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the world. For I was hungry, and you fed me. You walked in and you fed him right away. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. All he's gotten is living water since he's been here. I was a stranger, and you invited me into your home. Mm-hmm. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you cared for me. I was in prison, and you visited me.'" It's a pretty amazing thing that goes on here. And Steve embodies that. He really does. You know, God's been blessing him left and right. And it's because he has a servant's heart. His faith, you know. And he's become a completely other-centered person. He thinks about everybody else before himself, and that's an amazing thing. That's an amazing lesson for me, for all of us. Mm. And so, as Tom said, I'm really excited about the future because his future is really bright. You know, so Steve, if you want to say anything, please.
Well, you know, my life has changed because of, you know, people in this room. And because of God, you know, I battled alcohol for 30 years, and I honestly can't tell you exactly what day that it went away, what day that God took it, but, you know, that battle is over. Jesus has defeated that, has defeated alcohol for me in my life. You know, I appreciate the fact that I have a place to come, a family. You know, I've been truly blessed here, and you know, I've felt welcome. I've never felt like an outcast. You know, I paid my dues for the things I've done, and you know, now it's my time to right the wrongs. And you know, I love Step 7. I love what it stands for, and you know, I love what it does for people's lives. Because you know, it doesn't matter who you are, or where you come from. You know, Step 7 is about helping people beat addictions and change their lives. And I, you know, like Brian said, you know, 90 some days ago, I woke up in a prison cell. And if you had told me then that I'd be sitting here 90 days later, I don't think I'd have believed you. Mm-hmm. I didn't think it was possible. But I'm learning that all things are possible with God. And that, you know, if you take Jesus serious and you really, truly seek him and submit to him, the sky's the limit. So I thank everybody in this room for, you know, thoughts, prayers, food. You know, it's been a good journey, and I look forward to continuing. Thank you.
Steve, you've got a couple of gifts. Here is your diploma and graduating basic discipleship course. And here is your very own black shirt with Step 7 logo. As is our tradition, I'm going to invite whoever would like to come on up. We're going to gather around Steve. We're going to have a little time of prayer. Commission him onto this next phase in his life here. Brian, once everybody gets up here, why don't you start off? If anyone would like to pray after Brian's done, please go ahead, and then I will finish this out, okay?
Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning first and foremost to give you honor, thanks, and praise. I thank you for my buddy Steve. I pray that you would just reveal your glory to the rest of us through this man right here. Lord, it's such a remarkable thing what you can do when we just turn our hearts and our minds to you and we seek you. Lord, there you are every time. I pray that you would be with Steve in this next season of his life as he goes over to Paoli. Lord, I want to lift up the guys over there at Paoli, Phil and Matt and Ed. Lord, that you would just give them the words and the guidance, Lord, to help guide Steve and walk alongside Steve here in this next season of his life, Lord. I pray that you would just continue to bless him and bless all of us through him, Lord.
And what we have here, Heavenly Father, is a witness of your mighty love. The love of people in communion with one another, loving each other and reaching out to others. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the glory of you, your grace, and your mercy. May this young man continue in life now in a positive direction, a direction where he can reach out and touch other people. And let them know about the goodness and the love of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We rejoice in your name. And everybody said, Amen. Amen.
Lord, I too want to thank you for Steve. I want to thank you for being his rock. Just ask that you be with him and give him guidance and direction. Help him to make the right decisions that he needs to make for him. Help him mend relationships that he needs mended. Help him help us all over there, you know, to learn from each other, lean on each other. Help him be a light for you, Lord.
God, thank you for the blessings that you've shown our brother Steve here. And this is a great man and a huge heart, and it's just so amazing to see him grow and his walk with you, and you know
far, far forward. And he said, Brian will be worth it. Matt will be worth it. Randy will be worth it. Tom will be worth it. Nita will be worth it. And Steve will be worth it.
Lord, I want to thank you for bringing Steve to us. Lord, I'm always in awe of the twists and turns that bring each and every one of us to you. And Lord, I'm just so thankful for allowing my eyes to see the growth, Lord, the maturity that has occurred in this short time. And Lord, as we send him out into the next phase of his life here, Lord, I just ask that you would bring him with angels. Lord, you would guide his every thought, his every step, as he continues to grow deeper in love with you. And I pray all this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.